seconds to impact. 15. 40. 30. 20.
Oh my God, you were amazing. Amazing. Gwyneth has nothing on you, nothing. You are an amazing actor when you're in space. I can't believe you're gonna give all this up for some retired stunt guy who lives in Canada.
Terrence, thank you. But don't worry, okay? You're gonna be fine. You're gonna find another job. You're a really, really good assistant.
Yeah, hey, it's me. You all set? Yeah, but are you eating something right? I told you not to eat when you're on the phone with me. Okay, stop. Thank you. No, of course she'll have it with her. She takes everywhere she goes. All right, good. She'll be there in a week. I'll see you soon. Oh, and Louie, bring some Long Johns with you.
Did you know that the temperature in Saskatchewan at this time of year can get as low as minus 40? Hmm? Minus. Come on. How cold can it really be? Really cold.
Okay, I'm good. Meatball, wait up. Meatball, here. Come on.
Hey, I know you're nervous about Sabrina coming to live. Look, no one can ever replace your mother. I miss her too, Josh. Every day. Well, we made a promise to her. A promise we would live our lives and we'd be happy. It's been a long time since she passed. I know we'll be happy with Sabrina. And I know your mom would approve.
Dad, I want you to be happy too. I like Sabrina. I'm not worried about her. I just don't want to be left alone with Lacey.
No, it's not.
take time off of your career to get married. But it's completely unfair for you to torpedo mine before it even starts.
Is this about the reality show?
Of course it's about the reality show. It could have been a hit. Look at the endorsements. I could have had my own fashion line. Do you know how much Lena Gomez made off of her fashion line? You're 15. You should not be thinking about this kind of stuff. And the country is not going to be good for Cassie. She's an apartment/luxury hotel dwelling dog.
The country's gonna be great for Cassie. It's gonna be amazing for you. Okay? Yep.
Hey, Lace, you wanna come help me with the suitcases?
I already told you, it's freezing out there. Freezing!
Hey, you!
How are you?
Good. Oh, I missed you.
I missed you too, baby.
Hi, Josh. How are you?
I'm good.
Where is he? Meatball! Hey, come here!
Hi!
Good boy!
Hey, he stepped in poop. Did you see that? A poop stepped in poop.
What are you laughing at? That's not funny.
From where I'm standing, that's pretty funny.
These are expensive.
Oh, sorry.
Honey, we'll get it cleaned up. It's not that bad.
Is it any worse?
Ah, come on now. Come on, we're family now.
Ew, get him off of me. Ew, get him off of me.
There's something on you.
Get down, Meatball. Meatball. Come on, bud.
Hey, good. Get off of you, big... Wow, it is cold out here.
Hey, Josh, they got a cat. They got a little bitty kitty cat.
It's so cold. I'll be inside. It's freezing out here.
Where you going? You ain't loud up in there. Don't worry, everybody. I'll go in there and get her.
It's not warm in here either. Even these floors are cold. Where's the carpet?
Get back here, kitty cat.
I want to go back to L.A.
Bad kitty.
Drive the car. I want to go back home.
Someone help me out here. Oh, we got a wild kitty on the loose.
No jacuzzi, no steam room.
Hey, where you going?
How do you live like this?
Hey, you looking for something kitty-like, like a scratching post or a catnip or something?
I want to go back to L.A.
I know a guy who knows a guy. Maybe he can help you out.
Good. Someone called the police. Sheriff, get me out of here.
Hey, Meatball. Who's your new friend?
Watch out for this guy, kitty. He don't like cats.
Morning, Rick.
Hey, Sheriff, how you doing?
Good, thanks. These came in for you. Thought I'd save you the trip coming down to sign for him.
Okay, great. All right, thanks for swinging by.
No problem.
Dynamite. What's that for?
Yeah, we're cleaning out some boulders in the front of the property next month. Josh, why don't you show Lacey and Cassie your new room?
Okay. Hey, Sheriff.
Josh?
You're here to meet Sabrina, aren't you? Sabrina. Sheriff Carson.
Oh, hi, Sheriff.
Howdy, Miss Eastman. It's a real honor to meet you.
Oh, thanks.
You mind signing this for me?
No, of course not.
I'm a big fan of your movies.
Oh, really? Did you like Guns Blazing? That's the movie I met Rick on.
I'm more a fan of The Weeping Heart.
Oh.
Not a word.
All right.
See you folks later.
Bye.
Well, I'll stop in and check on the kids while you're away.
Thank you. You think they're gonna be okay?
They'll be fine. The kids, they'll get along. So, where is it?
Oh, it's in my bag. Come on, you wanna show me where the safe is?
Yeah, let me just put this in the shed.
Yep.
Question. Do you guys have running water?
Gosh, no. We get the water from a well, and the bathroom's an outhouse well. Half a mile yonder. No kidding. Of course we have running water.
And in your house?
Yes, just like a regular house.
Wow. You don't mess around.
It is a North Star diamond. Standing for your dad. I know how important it is to you.
very sweet of him. Yeah, he said as long as I
guys, a quick sponsor before we unpause it. Where I got the movie from is this good app, and it's called Tubi, T-U-B-I. And what's good about it is that you get free movies, and if you don't want to, like, do all the work where you put your email and your email password, just, you have to look around, but don't press, like, sign in or, like, any of that stuff. You have to look around, and you would see a X, and you press it, and you're able to still see the movies for free. Now, back to the movie.
Just show Lacey your room.
News this week as motion picture superstar Sabrina Eastman announces her extended break from show business. We caught up with Terrence Kitts, her longtime personal assistant, to find out more about her hiatus.
Just make sure I'm very tan. Do I look tan? Do I look tan, guys?
Isn't it true that since she's taken a break from movie work, you're out of job?
Unfortunately, Terrence stormed out after our first question. We can only assume he wanted to get to the unemployment office before closing.
Hello?
Oh, good. Crystal's here. Just in time.
Hi, Crystal.
Hey, everyone.
Hey, thanks again for watching the kids.
No problem at all. We're going to have a great time, aren't we, Josh?
This is Bentley.
Why? Something happens to you guys, you say it on the news.
Could you just say one nice thing to me?
I hope your honeymoon doesn't stink.
Hey. You'll be fine, it's just a week.
A week is just the start. She'll be here forever.
Run along now. You don't want to miss that plane.
The little dog's looking right at me.
It probably smells your bad breath or something. Okay, look. We wait until they go out, and then we make our move.
All right. Wait, why are we breaking in here again? Didn't you used to work for her?
Yeah, I used to work for her. Then she decided to quit making movies, and now I'm out of a job.
Right. But so why didn't you get another job?
Because I made too many enemies working for her.
You know, you should really work on that. You count more flies with sugar than you can with vinegar.
Catch more flies.
Pretty sure it's count.
I'm pretty sure it's catch. And in Hollywood, you gotta stick it to them before they stick it to you. It's the rule of the jungle. And now for my ultimate act of revenge, I'm gonna steal their precious North Star diamond and sell it to the buyer I set up and live like a king of the prophets.
Bobby, you cat sure can run fast. I mean, I had no idea a cat could run that fast.
I'm not a cat.
Not a cat? What do you like? Yeah. Sorry. It was all you can eat chili at Big Al's last night, and we have to understand.
No, not that boom. It's something else.
Hey, I think you're getting your country nose on.
My what?
Oh, yeah, you see, city dogs got a city nose, and a country dog got themselves a country nose. My range of smell is much greater than yours, so you're probably just smelling a skunk or something.
Skunk? I don't think I've ever seen one. Do they get pretty big?
Well, now they're about your size, but they smell a whole lot bigger, I'll tell you that for free.
Okay, well, that sounds really bad.
Oh, yeah, it's bad. It makes Big Al's chili look like a walk in the park. I can't even begin to
tell. I am so out of here.
Cassie?
Okay. We wait till it gets dark. We go back to the house. We see where we can get in. We do some reconnaissance.
Okay. Wait, reconnaissance? What?
Well, reconnaissance, it's an army term. I learned it in the cadets, but I had to quit because camping gave me diarrhea.
Right, right. I have to have a couple hot dogs.
Really?
I'm not joining the army, though.
You don't have to. Let's go.
OMG, there's no Wi-Fi? How am I supposed to get on the internet? My life is over.
No, you just have to...
What? Communicate with the outside world via smoke signals?
No, you just have to...
What? Do I need a shortwave ham radio or Morse code? Or maybe I'll just send faxes all day long.
We have Wi-Fi. You just have to enter the network password.
Oh, sorry. What is it?
It's Meatball 101.
Yeah, why's your dog named Meatball anyway?
Well, it was his favorite food. And he used his trick where... bounce a meatball on his nose, and then he'd flick it up in the air and catch it with his mouth.
That's a shame.
Yeah, he doesn't really do that.
Oh, I'm sorry. You think I care?
Isn't this exciting? A new sister.
Stepsister. I don't know, but it's not exciting. She's kind of a drama.
Well, she is from Hollywood. Give her a chance. She's in a new, unfamiliar place.
I'll give her a chance if she gives me a chance.
You two have more in common than you think.
This is bogus. You know how I was supposed to spend my winter vacation? On a reality show. It's gonna be all about me and my life. But Sabrina would sign the release.
Explains why you're such a crab cake at the wedding.
I was not a crab cake.
What is this?
Macrobiotic food.
Cool, I love macrobiotic food. I go into Hollywood and stuff.
This is stupid.
Oh, by the way, did Sabrina give me the recipe for Cassie's dog food?
I followed it to the letter.
Thank you.
Can you please not feed him the chunk of meatball?
Don't worry. It's very
good. Bring me those meatballs. Meatballs for meatballs. Well, what do you have?
A recipe for my holistic veterinarian.
You want a meatball?
Ew, gross. Ew.
What? Don't look at me.
Okay, which one of you is it?
Meatball, come on.
Unless the dog stops barking!
This is a lot of fun!
I know, I'm having fun too. Okay, go!
Josh, wake up, there's someone outside!
People were just barking at a raccoon or
something. No, I saw someone!
What's that?
Nothing. Where'd you see them?
Come on, let's go.
I don't see anything.
I saw him go that way.
Oh, Meatball, be quiet.
Meatball, be quiet.
Oh, Meatball. I love meatballs. I can really go for a meatball supper.
You should. Nice.
Yeah.
What exactly did you see?
There were shadows moving around.
Whoa, you woke me up for shadows?
Yeah, I woke you up for shadows.
Charlie Horse! Siri Payne! Stop it! No, Dr. Charles, Odin's ugly sister, I am going down!
What is it?
Come on! Get out of here!
I think I know what we're dealing with here.
Paparazzi, right? They're trying to get a shot of me living in the sticks.
Could be. Or it might be a couple of kids whose parents left them alone for a few days who need some attention. Josh, I expect better from you.
Lacey says she saw something.
Yeah? What'd they look like?
Shadows.
Look, kids, there's more campgrounds around here than I can count. Some folks enjoy tooling around the woods at night. Can't say I like it. But it's nothing to call the police over.
But Sharon!
When you kids called, I was having a nice little dream this morning with a touchdown in the Super Bowl. Now, if you don't mind, I'd like to get back in time for the after party.
All right, back to bed.
Why do you keep stopping?
Well, every time I take a step, I hear footsteps behind me.
Yeah, they're my footsteps. I'm behind you.
Why would I know that? I can't see anything. I dropped my flashlight.
Dropped your flashlight? Where did you drop your flashlight?
If I knew where I dropped my flashlight, I'd have a flashlight now, wouldn't I?
What is wrong with you?
I don't know.
Just go. God, nice recon mission.
He doesn't know what he's talking about. There was someone out there.
Thanks for getting me in trouble. You know, I don't know what I was thinking listening to you.
What, now you don't believe me?
You got me all freaked out for nothing. The sheriff was right. Just looking for attention.
Woo-wee! I would not go in there, Barry.
Whoa, good morning.
Wakey, wakey, eggs and bakey. Well, butter my biscuits. What is that on your face?
It's a sleeping mask.
Well, sleepy time's over. We got work to do.
Work? Have you lost your mind?
Come on, kitty cat. Shake a leg.
What is this work you speak of? Hey, I asked you a question.
Hey, did you hear that noise last night? Well, that was louder than a monster truck and tractor pull. Somebody was out here causing some kind of ruckus.
What was it? One of those skunk things?
No, it was like a people smell.
Is this a habit of yours, chasing every scent that catches your nose?
I'm a dog. It's what I do. I'm also a part-time wedding photographer.
What's that thing?
Right there's a flashlight. I think someone was out here last night with that flashlight and must have dropped it. Let's go check out the rest of the forest. Come on.
Whoa, what are you doing?
Meditating. Aligns the chakras and allows the energy to flow through.
Go and eat. I made you a hearty petit déjeuner. That's French for breakfast. It's on the counter.
Bacon. Please have to be bacon. Ah, oatmeal.
Oatmeal.
Wait, let me guess. Everyone in Hollywood eats this stuff.
Yeah, it's really good for you.
Sausages are good. Bacon.
Ew. Major artery cloggers.
I'm trapped in healthy paradise.
As I hate to be oppressive and act like a man, but after last night's escapades, I think you two need to keep busy today.
Why doesn't Lacey keep busy? It was her fault.
Pointing fingers doesn't solve anything. But you know what does? Good old-fashioned hard work. There's snow out there that needs to be shoveled and wood that needs chopping.
You're gonna at least help us, right?
No. Nope. Don't think of this as work. Think of it as getting back in touch with the earth.
More like getting back in touch with wildlife poop.
Come on, kitty cat, shake a leg! Two men, size 11 shoes, driving a van. Wait, a white van, and if I'm not mistaken, yeah, they had Big Al's chili last night. Come on, go in this way.
In those clothes?
What, do you expect me to wear gumboots and overalls?
Kind of, yeah. Just like that, you might as well be on a reality show.
What do you see?
They're really far away.
Is that how you use the binoculars?
Yes.
You need to turn them around.
I thought so. Okay.
Okay, what do you see?
The boy
is working out back. Okay, good. That was us. What else?
Okay. Oh, the girl just came outside.
Take it easy.
Go to waste. This has a video camera. You can take me doing work. I'll post on the internet and it'll be hilarious. My own reality show.
Okay, rolling. Make sure to say lots of funny remarks and stuff.
You got it. Hi, I'm Lacey and this is my show. Let me show you all about my life. Sorry.
Okay, tell you what. I'm gonna go get another shovel or axe, and I'll talk to you later, okay?
Okay. I'll keep going.
Yeah, whatever.
As you can see, this is way harder than it looks.
Okay, the boy is heading into the woods. Okay. Alright. There's just the lady in the house. We go in, plant the bugs, we find our safe retreat, and I'm gonna come back to the main show. He's at the house.
Yes!
Wait, does the girl know you want your arms here? No point. I got that covered.
We're here to check the gas lines. We've got a work order. They need to be checked.
Is there a problem?
No, nothing at all. It's a standard procedure. Although, I mean, this time of year, gas line goes, the whole place could go up in a fiery blaze!
Oh, my.
Yeah, fire, smoke everywhere.
It's all right, man. Like we said, it's just routine.
All right, but if you keep the noise to a minimum, I'm meditating.
Oh,
what?
Meditating? Contemplating the infinite.
Counting the what?
Ouch! Doesn't matter. We're gonna work. Stop elbowing me. That's asking stupid questions. It's all right, man. He's
severely neglected as a child. It's okay.
Of course. Come on, dear.
What a wonderful house you have here. Very, a lot of wood.
I smell something. OMG, I think my country nose is developing.
Cassie, wait! That there is not what you think it is.
Downstairs covered. You go inside.
I can crack this like a guy who just cracks crackers over soup, and then he eats the soup while he's cracking the same.
Now, once again, that's not an actual same. Sorry. Dusty down here.
You want me to do it now? It'll take about 15 minutes.
No, it's too risky right now. Not now.
Hey, it's like my dad always says, there's no time like the present.
It's present.
No present like the present? That doesn't make any sense.
Hello. Thought you boys might be thirsty.
Ooh, hot chocolate.
He is. Very, very, very nice of you.
I think I've discovered the meaning of the term backbreaking work. Why didn't you warn me it was a skunk?
You smell worse than a bathroom on a shrimp boat.
Cassie? Ew. What's that smell? It was an accident.
Cassie, why do you stink? And where's Josh?
Delicious.
Wait, aren't you the only one with a mustache?
Oh, absolutely. Nope. No, he has that kind of face.
That kind of face that people think he doesn't have a mustache?
Yep, exactly.
I was born with this mustache.
Okay,
thanks for the hot chocolate.
It's delicious. Delicious.
Got sprayed by a skunk.
What are we gonna do? She stinks. I cannot have a stinky dog.
What do you have for you?
Uh-oh. Uh-oh.
Meatball! Get back here! Meatball, settle down!
Me. Take my mustache, she's making it furious!
Bad dog, you get back here!
Who are those guys? Jazz Company.
I do smell like a bathroom on a shrimp boat.
Your
Like a charm.
Ew.
Hey, whoa, now, don't you need some of that for my meatballs?
Where were you? You were supposed to be helping me.
I got kind of bored listening to you talk about yourself.
Well, you could have at least helped with the work.
Hey, Lacey.
Where's Sabrina?
She's in front desk. I got a computer. What's wrong?
Well, Josh tricked me into shoveling the snow while he was doing who knows what. Cassie got sprayed by a skunk. I'm bored stiff, and there were strangers sneaking around outside last night.
Honey, calm down, all right? Let me talk to Crystal.
Fine.
I'm sorry they're being such a handful.
It's all right. They're just kids. How's the honeymoon?
Not good. Stuck in a Minneapolis airport hotel. There's a storm.
Oh, dear. Sorry to hear that.
Hi. Hey, how are the kids?
They've been better.
Oh, well, I have an idea. I mean, our honeymoon is pretty much wrecked, so, I mean, why don't we just come home early?
Mm-hmm. No, don't come home. Well, that's just great. Well, that's just great. Great. It's over. We're done. We are done. Dunzo. Now I'm gonna have to go back and look at my dad painting unicorn figurines. That's great!
Concierge can book us a train to Weyburn tomorrow morning.
It's about 60 kilometers away.
I'll pick you up.
Oh, okay. That's good. That's good. We are back in the game. You're back in the game. Yes.
Great. Train gets in at 11.
Okay, I'll bring the kids.
I have a better idea. Why don't we leave them and then we can surprise them when we get back?
Such a nice surprise for them. See you tomorrow.
Okay, bye.
Okay. Hey, relax. We'll get the kids out of the house, no problem.
Oh, yeah, how do you suppose we do that? What, lure them out with candy?
That was my plan B. But don't worry, I have a plan A. Where is it?
Where's what?
You know what I mean. My watch.
No idea what you're talking about.
Lacey, the watch that was in my room. Give it back.
I'm sorry, Josh, but I've never seen you wearing a watch.
Yes, you did. Last night when you woke me up.
What kind of a watch is it?
It's a watch, okay? You know what a watch looks like?
I'm sorry, Josh, but if you don't give me a detailed description, I really can't help you.
Look, I'm no squealer. But if you don't give the watch back, I'm going to tell Crystal you stole it.
Stole what?
My watch!
What's it look like again?
You little jerk. You know that?
Get back here, bad dog! Cassie, come on!
That a girl. See, I knew you.
What's all the barking about?
Cassie found your watch.
Why'd you take it?
I did it! I was mad at you. I wanted to make you look stupid, okay? I wanted to force you into admitting that you wear a girl's watch.
Why would you want to make... stupid? That wasn't just a girl's watch, okay? That was my mom's watch.
Oh. Josh, I'm sorry. I really didn't know.
Awkward. Why are you always on that thing?
Talking to my friends.
Last time I checked, talking actually involves speaking to one another. You should try it sometime.
Is that your mom?
No, just some random lady. Came with a frame. Okay, that's what I want.
She's really pretty.
Yeah, I know. Look. I know it seems silly to be keeping your watch, but it reminds me of her.
I wear these every day. No matter what I'm doing or where I'm going, I always have them with me.
Where are those wedding rings?
No, it came with a necklace.
Can I ask you something?
Yeah, sure.
Why are you so hard on Sabrina?
When I first went to live with her, she acted like my cool Aunt Sabrina. She used to take me to theme parks all the time, she'd buy me anything I wanted. Once, she rented a whole entire movie theater just so we could be the only ones there.
Cool.
Yeah. But then one day, she stopped acting like my aunt and started acting like my mom.
Well, she kind of is your mom.
Yeah, I know, but...
maybe she was spoiling you to take your mind off your...
I never thought of it that way.
Do you think they're still fighting?
No, I think they'll be fine. You know, that was a good thing you did.
Thanks, Meathead.
Don't mention it, Furball.
Alright, you think this will work?
Of course it's gonna work. I pulled the same trick when I was a kid. I wound up in juvenile hall. Oh. Yeah, but this time, it's totally gonna work.
No,
I'm not gonna wind up.
No, wait, does juvenile hall actually even exist anymore?
Of course it exists. Where do you think they send the bad kids?
Fat camp.
I told you I was a child.